Issa can definitely struggle up against the Volibear, who also has really good early game all-ins thanks to the passive and the bite next to a Tristana. This is a bot lane 2v2.
Maybe you can get in and try to make something happen on Fofo.
And that looks like this is exactly what it's going to be. Ask and you shall receive, Azeo. Goodbye to the Azir and first blood.
Done. You have to wonder if he had a bit more confidence to push in for that mid game.
Ooh, they're
going to
go for this.
Happened. Rest, level 6. I don't think he wants to dash back into that Renekton. Very bold play.
They're
going to
try
to put him down, but he's just going to try to finish the kill. He's going to grab one. You can't go in.
Now they can dive top lane. No ulti.
They want revenge. They've got the burst now to potentially finish off the Renekton. He dashes in the wave, gets all of his health back. There's no wave there anymore. They have to try to finish this one off, but still the Renekton is massive. The Hexdrago comes in, and this one's going to turn against him. The Renekton's still alive. Why are they doing this? Rest is outplaying every moment.
What?
And it felt like Levi had outplayed Hana in the early game. Pat was able to track here, so see the flash out. Might commit to the play anyway. Beautiful cast comes in from Hana, and right there, Kiaia is going to go down, donating the kill over to Fofo.
There between jungle, mid lane, and support. Now Zeros on the roam down. Koala has flash, though.
Koala, I think, needs to flash out of this one. The Ignite now comes down. Koala looks like he's just willing to give up his life in this one. Does not want to use any other resources in the trade.
That window right there where Levi had finished his jungle item. Now Hana just got him himself. Now it's three members in the top lane. Can they do
outside,
it?
Outside, third time's the charm. Three members is the charm. There's no way Renekton makes it out of this one. The Fury can't be enough. That's the shutdown. Going to go right
in and out of the fog board, but every time you come out, there's a W stun ready for Renekton.
Flips him back, though. The Alistar trouble already burned. The ultimate, too. He's going to feel dumb after that one. Now has to walk out of it, but they're not going to be able to finish the kill. Kiaia, and now it's Slay caught in the middle of the team. Just one very sad, lonely bear knocked out of the fight in these fights to come out on top.
They really do, but that being said, see if Kiaia can get
out
of this one.
That's a lot of CC, a good sidestep. Questionable body slam there. Now they might just look to turn. The TPs are coming in. The fight is raging back and forth, and they push the Akali back under. Zeros is desperately trying to escape. Levi trying to save the net. Zeros is still alive. Zeros has managed to make it out. No, the Renekton on the back side. Fofo grabbing yet another day. The headbutt pulverize. That's about all he can do,
though.
I thought
you were going to say the defensive capabilities as he was running away.
I was ready for that.
Right. Gam just want to keep finding these isolated, smaller skirmishes or pick tools because, remember, they do still have a lot of damage. They're lacking in frontline. They're lacking in reliable engage. That's why we think team fighting is a little bit more difficult for them. But if they find fights around, you know, a strong Kiaia plus Levi, Zeros 2, once he finishes off that Gunblade, should be a whole lot more powerful.
Shuffle goes in, pushes him right out of the shroud. There's no chance for the Akali to escape. She's going to have to burn everything if she wants to get out. Zeros will go down. To extend their lead. They've already got double Drakes. 6 kills to 4. 1 tower to 1, looking to make it a second one, but still giving Zeros enough respect. Not really risking anything, and I think it makes sense. When you look at the scaling, it feels pretty easy for them to move later into the game. Zeros, though, a lot more confident than 1v1. The ult is still up. I feel like he should slow play this one, but
just
is going to dash in anyway. The rest of the team is now here. The Volibear now going in. It is one scary bear using the ultimate, trying to finish this kill off. They dash in, but Rest is still alive. He gets the stun. He's still able to make it out of this one. They want to kill him so bad. Levi will get it, and that's the Rampage. But the Alistar goes down, trying to protect
here
him.
Here comes Little
B! Comes in. Levi goes golden. There's a brief break before the fight continues now. The cask is knocked back. The Volibear gets taken down. A messy fight.
At the end, they should be able to pick up this tower.
Fofo, easy for him to knock that one down. And gentlemen, there is good news. Levi has gotten more money. This is a bit ambitious. He's just going to push him right into the Gragas. That is not the play that they were looking for, but Kiaia still alive. Not on the way in. The heal has come out. Now they're trying to chase the target down. Volibear is here as well. Hex flash over the wall. Going in, wants to finish the kill. Knocks the Gragas back. That's going to be one. Tristana has the reset. She needs to make it out to safety, but she gets knocked back under the tower. Leaps in instead. He sets his sight on Fofo, but no, Fofo gets it. The shield from the Shifting Sands barely keeping him alive.
Wow, Levi has a lot of kills, a lot of gold. He's actually building 3 different items up over the years to just kind of play this calm, slow, side lane style game. They overwhelmed their opponent on Lilvi over Zin, and that is just enormous.
Next flash bear, they're going to go in, they kick him back, they knock, he can't do anything! That's the death brush! Gam's still able to find the kill, Gragas fishing for the disengage, the rest of the team on the way in, but he's going to get taken down, and the bear has finally found purpose in the game, and it is to absolutely eat this Gragas. Gam and JT don't have an incentive to step forward, Zeros. This is Rest on the bottom side of the map, but now the Renekton's in the pit. He's on the backside. He's going to dash right back out. It's slow and it's steady, but members are going to start to respawn. Fofo getting closer and closer. TP up and available. Can move into
TP
the
TP flank.
3K getting lower and lower. Eyes on the Baron. They're going to leap in anyway. Zin goes in, but the Alistar goes in. The follow-up is there, and Rest has taken out the AK. Fofo pushes them all back into the pit. He says, you want it. You got it. It's a clean sweep coming out from the side of J-Team. They have just murdered Gam's dreams.
They got the clean ace. They got
finish it.
Gam just kept looking when to find the turn, when they could actually make that play happen, but they don't have the engage tools. It's so hard.
The damage from just the Baron fight, but the patience was fantastic from the side of JT. They only committed to the pit when they saw the Baron was actually potentially going to drop.
So, I mean, you guys were making fun of Volibear scaling. He can just as much as late game Tristana. I mean, it seems really good to me.
Don't do him like that. That's...
I mean, they have to recall. Tristana's still mid lane. Ryze is top lane. They're just going for the base right now.
They're just
going
to end the game. This is a perfect setup for Azir. The sieging, it's going to be easy for him to continue to poke down. Maybe one final fight for the side of Gam. J-Team running out of minions, a wave behind them.
Again, though, how do Gam force the fight? Like, they got a Realm Warp, maybe put the Volibear in the back line.
That's,
this is what we've been waiting
it.
For.
Time for an 80 damage Volibear to make his name in the competitive scene. Okay, Slade does not have that cooldown, and they are just slowly getting chipped away.
You gotta do something.
It's the last chance for the Gigabyte Marines. They have to find a fight now. The Gragas push them away from the base. The Renekton clearing the waves in the meantime, but no one wants to go in. The Gragas cooldown being down does give Gam a slight advantage in the fight to come. Still going up against a Monumental Gold lead and a Baron buff and BM from Rest. Remember, Gam go out here if they lose. Everything is on the line in this final fight. Continue in. Volibear fishing.
He's still doing it!
Scared. They're just BMing. They're just pulling him back with the reactive back. Just gonna cut down. No, he cuts through the Volibear instantly, and they're setting their sights instead of the Nexus. They don't care about the kills. They want the win. They want their way out of groups. J-Team are going to knock Gam out of the tournament.